I'm going to make this tiny little church, and as you can see in the picture, you can put some light in it if you like to. But I'm going to show you another way to make it. You can make it like this, or the way I'm going to show you. So let's get started. I have found my pattern. You can find the links for that in the info box. And I cut them out. And then I took some gray colored clay and mixed it with a little black so it got a little darker. And I'm going to cut out my pieces of this clay. And I rolled it out in a sitting, let's see, that was a sitting three. And I'm going to cut out two of these. I cut out two pieces of this one for the building. And then I have two different smaller ones here. Ends of the house, and I'm going to cut them out as well. And that's an end for here and here. And then I have a long one for here. And I need all three of them, one of each. And I'm going to put this bit to the side for later, if I want to make more. And now I'm going to decide for a few windows. And you can put them on first if you like to, and then cut them out. But I'm just going to cut out right away. The end of the house, and I'm going to make a door here. So I have my windows cut out. I'm not going to make one in this one. I put my other pieces over to my baking tray, but here is my piece with the door. And then I had some clay in a caramel color, and I'm going to make the door for my church. You can leave this part out if you don't like to have a door. I do, so I'm going to cut out a door here for my church. And I'm going to put it in, and I'm going to make some wood markings in it. I like it to look a bit like a wood, and I take some brown color clay and I give it just a bit. And then I'm taking this and rolling out a tiny sausage for making the door frame. If you don't want to do all this, you can also paint it on. I just don't want to use that much paint on my things, so I'm not gonna do that. So here I'm going to put, here's my door frame. I baked the parts for my house. Now I'm going to glue them together. For that I'm just using some strong glue. If you have some poly binder, you can use that as well. But I don't, so I'm going to use this one. So I'm taking some of my glue and put it on. And going to connect the house. And then I'm going to leave my little church to dry, and then I will come back. I glued my church together, and as I mixed up these two parts, please don't do that, then I had to cut off a tiny bit here to make the roof sit right. I have two on the patterns. I have two different roof sizes, and I'm going to use the big one only, but actually it's the big one and the small one, so you can make these pieces stand out and not lay the roof over it. But I'm not gonna do that on this house, so I'm going to I'm gonna take the big one. And I took some Xmas red clay and I rolled it out on my thickest settings on the pasta machine. You can do it on the setting you like, but I like it to be bigger. And this is supposed to be bent on the middle, so I'm going to do that, bending it for the top of the house, and I'm actually opening it again. Then I have this round cutter, and I'm going to make some indents on my clay. And then I take some baking bond, or you can use a fimo liquid gel as well. I like baking bond because I think it's a little more sticky than liquid gel. And I'm putting it on everywhere I want my roof to stick. And then I'm just going to place my roof and squeeze it tight so that it sticks onto the house. And I'm going to shape it so I have it placed like I like it. So it sits tight around the end and it's looking good over the house. And don't worry about the gray house, we're going to work on that later. And I'm going to make one more roof for the top here. So here I have my church building with the roof on. I baked my little church building. So now we have the roof and the walls and a tiny door. And now for the fun part, the bricks. And for that I'm taking some opaque white, some gray, and I have the leftovers from my house, so I'm just mixing that in. I'm mixing these two colors, and then I have some black craft sand, and I'm going to mix some of that into it also to make some granite looking clay. You can also use some granite looking clay, but I don't have that, so I'm going to mix my own. I will be right back. I mix my clay, and it's not all uniform colored, because I like to have some kind of shadows, whatever you like it, in my bricks. But I rolled it out in the second smallest setting I have on my new pasta machine. And I'm going to make my bricks in this one, on this house, I'm going to make normal bricks. And for that I'm just cutting off a straight edge here, like that. And I'm cutting it into thin slices. So, I have a lot of stones ready. And now for my building. I take my baking bond, but you can use fimo liquid gel as well. But again, I like my baking bond. And I'm going to put it on my house or church where I need my bricks to go. I am starting with two sides, the end and one side here, and I am not going up in the tower right now, but you can do the building up like you want to, like that. So I have my baking bond on my house. Now I just take my rocks one by one, placing them on my building. And putting a tiny bit of space in between. I'm just going to show you how I make the windows. I'm actually just placing the bricks around the windows, let them sit there for a tiny bit, and then I take a dotting tool and I work around the window, pushing down the bricks so they fit for the window frame. And this is making a neat little window frame also. So that's very easy way to make the windows. I have bricks all over my house now, and it looks good. And I'm going to give it a bit of texture, a bit more. And for that I have a toothbrush. And I'm going just to slightly and carefully give it some toothbrush texture all over. And when I'm done with that, I am going to bake it. I'm back and I'm going to show you another way to do it. I put baking bond on this house and I have rolled out my cane of clay in a small sausage, and I'm taking off small pieces here and rolling them. Then I take with my dotting tool one of these rolled dots and I stick it to the house where I like it, and I'm just dotting it out on the surface of the church. Okay, let me take one more, just a tiny one, into a bowl, place it on the baking bond. You can use liquid fimo gel. I don't like that for this part because it's not as sticky as a baking bond. And then I'm just dotting it out over the house so that I still see the dark gray here and there between the small dots. This is also a way to do it, and you can put darker stones in there if you'd like to. So it's only up to your imagination. So I will show you a few pictures later, but happy crafting!